How to take care of your aquaponics system while you are going on holiday. This is what we're going to see together in this video. Hi, my name is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics and I make videos to help you to manage your aquaponics system in the best conditions in your backyard in order to grow some food, sustainable, healthy and tasty. I'm talking about vegetables and fish in your own backyard. So I receive a lot of questions of people who want to start aquaponics, but they are scared because they don't want to commit. They don't know how to deal with the system while they go on holiday. And actually, I'm just back from holiday today, from 2 weeks of holidays. So the systems behind me, they have been running for 2 weeks without anything, without any maintenance, without any fish food, without adding water in the system, nothing. And as you can see, I come back and everything is green. While I live in Melbourne, and in Melbourne the weather is very hot, very warm. The normal gardeners, they have to water the garden every day. And if they go on holiday during summertime, everything will be dead, everything will be dry. While here, you see, I'm going on holiday, I come back and everything is green. So that's really a very interesting point in aquaponics. We can go on holiday without problem, and when we come back, everything is great. Because the system is a real ecosystem actually, and all living creatures are living together, and the water that is present into the fish tank is always distributed into the grow bed. So it's always present for the plants. The plants have always access to some water, but also to the nutrients of the system. That's really the beauty of the thing. So the only limiting part are, you know, in summer you still have a bit of evaporation. So if you don't have a lot of a big fish tank or a sump tank is another tank that is working as a reservoir of water. So if you don't have much water in your system, you may have some evaporation. And if you go on holiday for months, while the temperature is at plus 40 or something, like very, very hot, plus 30, it can evaporate and you decrease, the water level decrease. So if you go on holiday for too long, after a while, you don't have water remaining in your system. But it's generally not such a big problem if you don't live in such a warm environment. For the fish, you don't really need to feed them. I have been on holiday for weeks, and when I come back, the fish are all alive, they are really healthy. Obviously, when I distribute some food, when I feed them, they all eat very well. So they were quite hungry, but at least they all survive. It's better than having an automatic feeding system where the fish food is going to drop in the fish tank. Even if the fish don't eat or if there is a problem on the water pump, that would be a big issue, because then the ammonia in the system, the toxicity of the water is going to increase. While here, when I am not present, and when I know that I'm not going to be present every day to see the fish, I don't feed them. I prefer not giving them any food than giving them some food that they don't eat, and then obviously it's going to be really bad for the ecosystem. And if there is a problem with water pump or an air pump, the fish can simply die. So that's my biggest recommendation: don't feed your fish if you go on holidays. In terms of plants, obviously I was not here, so you see I got some tomato here that is growing in a vine. I got a lot of tomato plants. They grow from those grow beds and they grow high, and then I attach them to some cables so they can grow in a vine and they create some shed. So it's very good. The only thing is I always got some dead leaves, so I will need to do a little bit of cleanup. Just removing those dead leaves. They are not really a problem for the system, it's just that I like to keep it tidy and clean, but it's not a real issue. And obviously I got a lot of tomatoes here that are really ready to be eaten, so I should have collected some last week, but I was not here obviously, so some of them are maybe over maturate, so they may be overripe. So I will see, maybe some of them I will give to the chicken because they may not be the best to eat. But otherwise, all the veggies, all the plants are growing really well. There is one that I found on the floor. That's a nice cucumber. So the plant was dead, you know, it produced pretty well. So I had one fruit hanging from the side, and obviously with time it fall down. So when I arrived, I found this one on the floor, a nice fruit ready to eat. So nice zucchini actually. And that's it. So very easy, very simple. So you see, I come back, I just have to top up the water a little bit, add a bit more water in the system, feed my fish, and then I can harvest the tomatoes. And that's it. Very, very simple, very easy. It's not a big job. I go on holiday for weeks, I come back, everything is green in my backyard. That's the real revolution of aquaponics compared to a classic garden where you would lose everything. You would have to ask someone to come and to water your garden every day. So I hope you enjoy this video. If you are new to aquaponics, I offer a free guide in the description of this video just below, or in the I like information in the corner of the video. You click on it and you're going to find a link to a free training to help you to build your own aquaponic system, but also to maintain and manage it in the best condition possible for you and for your ecosystem. If you enjoy the video, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel, because I will share one video every week with you in order to succeed in aquaponics. I see you in the next one, and bye bye. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!